So today I'm talking with Dr. Jiming Sun from right here at Georgia Tech. Jiming joined us earlier this year after many years at IBM, where his work has depended heavily on analyzing data from electronic health records. Jiming, thanks very much for taking the time to be in the course. I've heard you talk many times about the difficulties of working with EHR data. Could you explain some of those to the students?
Sure. First, Mark, great to be here. So electronic health record is very important for my research and many other people who work on clinical informatics, healthcare informatics also need to access electronic health record. But electronic health record is very messy. There are a lot of missing data in there because they are collected for billing and clinical operation purpose. They're not designed for research. So there are a lot of information in EHR systems, but for a given patient, they only have a small subset of those, and they're not uniform. So some patients have a lot more information than the others, and that makes the electronic health record very messy, very difficult to deal with. The other thing is there are just a lot of different kind of information that are in EHR systems, and it's getting more and more. For example, there are diagnosis information such as ICD code in there, and there are medication information, there's lab test, and there are clinical notes represented as free text, and there are medical images, and more genomic data getting into EHR system. So all of those different type of information requires different kind of techniques to process them, to analyze them. For example, for text data, like clinical notes, you need natural language processing. And for image, you need specialized medical image analysis tools. For structured data, like diagnosis, medications, you would use general machine learning data mining techniques. So people have to be able to pick the right tools to deal with the right data.
Well, in a moment, we're going to talk about some work you've done around the early diagnosis of congestive heart failure, which is interesting, particularly within the context of this course, because chronic disease has really been the exemplar I've used throughout. But first, in that work, you've had to use that free text data. And in fact, you've extracted from it clinical features that can be used by machine learning algorithms. So how do you do that? How does that work?
Right, so first, for people who are not so familiar with clinical notes, it's very rich information, a lot of subtlety, and a lot of symptoms are represented in the notes, only in the notes, not in the structured data. So it's very important to process the clinical notes to extract those symptom information, the severity information that are hidden in the text. So that's the reason why we need to process clinical notes. And the way we did that is to use a software pipeline for dealing with text called UEMA, so it's Unstructured Information Management Architecture, that's originally developed at IBM Research, later on become an open source project that many people are using that, including the later on the Watson project. So it's facilitate natural language processing development, and you develop a pipeline of extractors to go through the text, extracting the information that you care about, like symptoms that related to heart failures. So we used Framingham heart failure signs and symptoms, and also the context, right? So you not only want to know the symptoms are present in the text, but also whether it's in a positive context, meaning that the patient is confirmed to have the symptoms, or is in a negative context, is the patient doesn't have the symptoms. So you also need to know the context. So we did many different extractors and to extract that information and also the context. So it's a lot of work.
So armed with that information and the structured information, you've developed a machine learning algorithm to diagnose congestive heart failure earlier. I should mention to the students without a clinical background that congestive heart failure is the single most expensive medical condition. and that diagnosing and treating it early, as we've discussed in the course, is true of most chronic diseases, we can hope to avoid the complications that are very expensive to treat. But it's very subtle at first. There is no test like a blood glucose you can take or a hemoglobin A1C to say you've got congestive heart failure. So clinicians often don't pick up on it as early as it might be the case. Your model does. Can you tell us how you did that?
Right. So that's a project we started when I was at IBM Research a few years ago in collaboration with Geisinger Health Systems. So we visit Geisinger and, I mean, trying to learn about what are the most important or challenging problems that we can tackle together using data mining machine learning techniques. And they identified heart failure as one. And at the times, there are already many groups are interested in heart failures, mostly in the post-diagnosis phases in terms of readmission, hospitalization, readmission after heart failure's diagnosis. But that group in Geisinger, they wanted to look at pre-diagnosis, look at what are the signs and symptoms that lead to diagnosis of heart failure. Can we identify the patient of high risk of developing heart failures earlier? So the goal is for early detection. And we leverage, the first thing we did is we want to see whether that's even possible. Are there relevant signal in the data that earlier than the diagnosis time? And we look at the clinical notes. And that's where we first developed natural language processing techniques to extract that. And the findings from those notes are very shocking. In fact, just the finding from the clinical notes were able to publish in a journal in cardiac failures, and that's a medical journal that clinicians read. There is some exciting findings in terms of signs and symptoms that are in the electronic health records 2 years prior to the diagnosis, and it's very surprising. Many people don't believe those, I mean, 40% of patients have that signs and symptoms already in the clinical notes that 2 years before the diagnosis. So those make us believe we can do something. Then the question is, how do we really leverage that rich EHR information? So we build integrated data analysis tools to integrate diagnosis, lab measure, and medication, and also clinical notes together to build a very rich patient profiles, then score those patient profiles using advanced machine learning techniques to build a predictive model. And that helped us to develop this very accurate predictive model that can predict heart failure's diagnosis 6 to 12 months before the actual diagnosis.